Hello and welcome to Azure Wala YouTube channel. We are in part 32 of Microsoft Certified Associate series. So far we have completed 61 questions in previous videos. Today we are going to look into question number 62. You have an Azure subscription linked to an Azure Active Directory tenant. The tenant includes a user account named user1. You need to ensure that user1 can assign a policy to tenant root management group. What should you do? The tenant root management group is the top level management group for Active Directory tenant. The global administrator has access to all administrative features. So first of all, we will have to elevate the user one to global administrator role or assign the global administrator role to user one. Still, we will not be able to assign the policy using the user one to tenant root management group. For that, we will have to elevate access for the global administrator. Means first step is the role assignment on the user one to the global administrator, and second one we will have to elevate the permissions or access to the user one. Let's see on the Azure portal. We have created a user one in Azure portal and we are going to see the assigned role right now. So there is no active role assigned to user one right now. We will quickly assign the global administrator role to user one. Before we assign the user one global administrator privileges, let's quickly check for elevation option in Active Directory. So we'll go to default directory in properties and we can see here that we cannot elevate the access management for Azure resources as a second step because this yes and no button is disabled. We will quickly assign the global administrator role to user one and we'll check this again. So we are logged in as user one right now. I have switched to my administrator account and to assign the permissions for user one. So I'm in default directory in users and user one is selected. I'll go to assign roles, add assignment, global administrator. Next, eligible, active. Testing assign. So a role is under assignment and it is assigned. I can refresh it. After waiting for a while, I can see that my active assignment is global administrator now. I can go back to my user one account and refresh it. Let me try refresh. My user one is still disabled, so I will have to log out and log in again. I am logged in as user one. I'll go to Active Directory. I'll go to properties. And I can see now it is activated, means now I can elevate this permissions for user one. So it confirms the two steps of this process. That first step is we have to assign global administrator role to the user one. Second step, we can elevate this permission. Before elevating this permission, let's check in the policy. So we go to policy here, and we can see here we can choose the subscription thing. Let's try policy again. After few refresh, I can see here subscription. I can click here, I can select the subscription, but still I cannot see the management group here. So I need to elevate the permissions. To elevate the permission, I will quickly go to Active Directory. I'll go to properties and I'll press yes and save it. After waiting for a while, we can go to management groups and able to select tenant group and assign the policy to that. So now it's working for us. Earlier it was not, we were not able to select from here, but yes, we are able to go to management group and assign the group policy on the management root management level. So now concept is clear to us, and now we can answer this question easily. That the first step, we can see that we have to assign a global administrator role for the user one. So once the user one has the global administrator role assigned, then we can instruct the user one to configure access level or access management for the Azure resource where we have yes and no. So once we do this elevation, we can see the top management, top tenant root management group, and we can assign this. So option C is correct. If in the exam it comes with the owner role, it is definitely going to be wrong only. So be careful, it is on subscription level, not on the management level. And another option D is just create new management. That is definitely not the answer, because we are talking about the top tenant root management group. So option C is the correct answer. Thank you for watching this video, and I hope you like the solution. Please do like, subscribe, press the bell notification icon, share with your friends. See you in next video. Thank you.